Well, Rupert has spotted something. This could be it. A walking tree on the move. But what Rupert had in fact discovered was something very different. The Turkish little rood plant. This remarkably smutty piece of flora was used by the Turks to ram up each other's... Ah, no. In fact, it was something even more interesting. Yes, there it was, over the other side of the clearing. The legendary puking tree of Mozambique.
No, what they had come across was a tribe lost to man since time immemorial. The legendary batsmen of the Kalahari.
Primitive customs still survive here, as if the march of time had passed them by. But for all the mumbo-jumbo and superstition, the batsmen of the Kalahari are formidable fighters, as we can see on this rare footage of them in action against Warwickshire.
Warwickshire had dismissed the Kalahari batsmen for 140. And then it was their turn to face this extraordinary Kalahari attack. Pratt was the first to go, but Pratt put on a second wicket stand of naught, which was broken by Odinga in his most hostile mood.
That's B. Pratt, hit wicket, naught. But Pratt and Zed Pratt dug in and took the score to a half. Before Zed Pratt ran away. But out came MJK Pratt to play a real captain's innings. He'd taken his own score up to naught when he mistimed a shot of Bawanga and was LBW. Typical of Umbonga's hostile opening spell was his dismissal of V.E. Pratt, who offered no resistance to this delivery. And he was put to her.
But by lunch, the situation had changed dramatically.
C.U. Pratt killed outright, bowled Odinga, naught. P.B.T.R. Pratt, legs off before wicket, bowled Odinga, naught. BBC TV Pratt, assegai up Jaxie, bowled Umboko, naught. Zed Pratt, machete before wicket, bowled Umbonga, naught. MJK Pratt, stumped through head, bowled Umbonga, naught. VE Pratt, ran away, naught. PDA Pratt, retired hurt, naught. WG Pratt, retired very hurt, naught. Pratt, died of fright, bowled Odinga, naught. Y-E-T-A-N-O-T-H-E-R Pratt, not out, but dreadfully hurt, 139.
And so, with the tension colossal as we come up to the last ball, that's all from us.
Good evening. Over 400,000 million pounds were wiped off the value of shares this afternoon when someone in the stock exchange coughed. Sport. Capital punishment is to be reintroduced in the first and second division. Any player found tackling from behind or controlling the ball with the lower part of the arm will be hanged. But the electric chair remains the standard punishment for threatening the goalie. Referees chairman Len Goebbels said, at last the referee has been given teeth. Finally, politics. The latest opinion poll published today shows Labour ahead with 40%, The AA second with 38%. And not surprisingly, Kentucky Fried Chicken running the Liberals a very close third. And now, back to me. Hello. And now it's time to go over to Hugh Delaney at Paignton.
Hello and welcome to Paignton. Because it's from Paignton that we take you straight back to the studio.
Hello. And it's from here we go over there.
Well, we're already here, so let's go over there.
Welcome back. And now it's time for part 8 of our series about the life and work of Ursula Hitler, the Surrey housewife who revolutionised British beekeeping in the 1930s.
That was a party political podcast on behalf of the Liberal Party.